your parents put between the left side and right side, right? And then but even you put an asset, like say $6,000.
Absolutely correct.
So you reduce cash by $6,000, how can you balance the $6,000?
His question is very good, right? Because doesn't matter those accounts belong to assets, liability, or equity. Doesn't matter what category they are, right? We must balance. Balance usually means we have 6,000 right now on the right side. This problem is no problem, right? This part is okay. We pay our 6,000. They really mean 6,000 cash reduced from our position. We don't possess 6,000 anymore. We pay out to somebody else. How can we get it balanced on the left side? How can we? Yeah, we can do it because the other two accounts, they are all assets. When assets increase, they are on the left side. Understand? Because we create one is called security deposit. This is security deposit. And we just define this as assets. When assets increase, we increase this. Then we have a prepaid. Be careful, when I say prepaid is assets, really mean you prepay to somebody else, okay? If somebody prepay to you, I will give you an example very soon. That's your liability. Okay, this opposite. I will give you opposite example right away. But right now, since this is your company prepaid to landlord, so this is the assets. When assets increase, you have a twice. So we balance, right? 2,000, 4,000, then we balance. We have 6,000 total.
Security deposit
is 2,000.
We pay 4,000.
Yeah, so we have two accounts. One is a security deposit. The other is, let me ask you one question, okay? You can have your different idea, okay? Because in the accounting world, you don't necessarily follow my rule. As long as you fully comply with GAAP, as long as your method comply with the general accounting principle, it should be fine. But let me ask you, why do you want to separate security deposit from prepaid rent? Why? What's the reason why? For small company, probably you don't care. But for big company, you want to identify each item clearly, right? So how come you want to separate? Because you pay one check, by the way. You pay one check to the landlord. However, for your accounting people, you will ask them to do two entry. The reason why?
Because the security deposit will be able to receive that one day in the future.
Yes. The reason why you want to separate two accounts, because I will give you an example very soon. Okay. Because the prepaid rent is subject to adjustment. The topic for today from chapter, I believe it's chapter 4. By the way, I never try to read the book, okay? I think the major topic for chapter 4 is called adjustment. I will give you an example. And security deposit is not subject to adjustment versus prepaid. For prepaid, we will do adjustment very quickly. I will give you an example very soon. And that's the reason why, even though both of them belong to assets, however, preferably, you want to have a two account. Because the security deposit is not subject to adjustment. You expect to get it back, assuming there's no damage to the property. You will get the fully refund. So that's always become your asset. Only by the time the landlord give you the notice, say, I will charge you $500 for cleaning, or $1,000 for painting, whatsoever. And you agree, then you report as expenses. Otherwise, security deposit is always your assets. Yes, go ahead.
So when you pay the rent here, $2,000 for the first month, right? and then you move things, then still under prepare or?
Yeah, so right now eventually his questions is our next example. So assuming this is no problem, I want to make sure everybody agree so far. On the day your company pays $6,000 total, you enter into three accounts. One is cash reduced by $6,000, and security deposit account increased by $2,000, and prepaid rent increased by $4,000. And assuming the day your company move in, let me ask you, the day your company move in, what the moving affect your accounting? On the day you're moving, what this? We always say transaction, right? Because for the accounting, we always say, oh, this transaction, blah, blah, blah. But is moving as a transaction? Because it must be a transaction, then it affect your accounting. So let me ask you one fundamental issue. The day your company moving the furniture, your computer equipment, you start to operate at the facility, does this moving count as transaction?
Yes. So the expenses associated with it.
So does your company, if you are accounting people, on the day your company moving, would you do any accounting? Did you do any accounting on your book?
You start using this rent.
Say it again?
You start using this rent. So basically you move in and then you lease that.
Yeah, eventually let me explore his idea. Since my company moved in, so we are ready to start using our prepaid rent. So maybe this is the reason why as accounting people I start to enter some expenses. I fully agree with his idea. However, the question is, how often you want to enter into? Because every second, you are using your rent, right? So you can do it by second, by minute, by hour, by day. So in real life, we don't do that, right? In real life, for the rent, usually we do it once a month. So I just want to give you, before I give you the conclusion, I just give you the reason why.
Oh.
I just give you the reason why, how come by the time your company moving the day one, probably you don't do anything for this. Probably. Even though I said, fully agree with you, once you move in, your company start to use the facility, every second you use up your prepaid assets, every second. But the issue is how often you will adjust your bookkeeping. You don't do it by second, by minute, by hour, by day. You do it by month. So the answer is by the day you move in, you don't do anything. Understand? Then by the end of the month, then we start to change our accounting. When we say we change your accounting, that is chapter 4, adjustment.
In this case, how do you adjust?
I will do it. So any other input, any other suggest so far?
Right. How about other equipment?
Same thing. Yeah, if you have any other equipment, I'll give example very soon. If I did not remind me, okay, because that's the whole thing for today. For today is called adjustment. And if not today, we have another specific chapter to deal with about the equipment, that's depreciation. But we'll mention a little bit, we'll touch it a little bit. Alright. Okay, so by the end of the month, so your company moving for a month already. So right now you know your company already used up the first month prepaid rent. So by the end of the first month, just for this rent, okay, we don't talk about any other thing. Just related to this rent. How will you do to deal with this rent issue? Pick out the account. What kind of account you want to pick?
Expense for $2,000.
Yeah, we pick out the expense account first, right? And more specify which expenses, because expenses is a big category. You want to create one new account under the name rent expenses. Rent. If you are a big company of so many rent, you need to specify rent number one, building one rent, building two rent, so and so. But assuming just very simple, only one facility. So you create one new account, it's called rent, R-E-N-T, rent expense. All right, so I have one new account. How about the other account? Who want to pick? Prepay. Existed there. Already there. So let's see. We have the rent expense. So this is the expense. Oh, doesn't matter which one is first, okay? You can do the prepay rent first because it's easier. You will not make a mistake. So when you do the prepay rent, total 4,000, because this is the assets, right? When you use all your assets, so then we reduce, right? So cannot be wrong, you must put down 2,000 here on the credit side. Any questions so far? Because this is easy. Cannot be on this side, right? Because you prepay, right now you gradually use up. You use up by 1 month, so you reduce by 1 month's rent. So you if you have 2,000 on the right side and the other must be 2,000 on the left side, this is almost no brainer. So that's why the rule is here. When expenses increase, it's on the left side.
So do you mean the expenses?
Hold on 1 second. I want to give everybody a moment. 1 second pause. Sometimes pause is even more important than continue, okay? Sometimes 5 second pause is very important. I want to get idea why, how come when expenses increase is on the left side. There is no any correlation between expenses to assets, no any correlation. It's just coincident, okay? Just coincident. When expenses increase is on the debit side. And this is the proof. Just give proof or example. Otherwise, you cannot get it balanced. Okay, I'm sorry, go back to your questions.
Oh, okay, so that expenses and revenue.
Say it again. One more time. I think I understood, but say it again. You mean?
Okay, so when revenue the expenses would be the net profit, is that?
Yes, expenses is always the negative to revenue. So did I answer your questions? When we talk about expenses, so many account under the expenses, right? When we, all the time when we talk about expenses, is the expenses appear on the income statement. Finally, it will appear on the income statement.
But now you have expenses.
This is an account, this is individual. This is individual T account. Hold on 1 second, don't. You understand? Right now we try to create each single individual expenses account. So rent is one of the expenses account. So by the end of the period, we're gonna add out all everything expenses and appear as one number and carry that number to the income statement. So we have a total revenue, we will see that later on. Total revenue as one number and minus total expenses as one number, and the bottom line is either profit or loss. So the reason why right now we create only one account, because rent is only one account, it's not total. So I still try to understand your question. Do I answer your question so far?
Yeah, just curious how come the expenses, one of the expenses account will relate to the pay, which is belongs to assets, because they are totally different.
Yes, there is no, again, okay. For each single individual expenses, no any correlation to assets. Sometimes, I'll give you another example. Sometimes expenses relate to your liability. It's called, what he said. He said, tax payable, you said, tax payable. Sometimes you report your expenses first, but not yet pay. Then you report expenses. However, this time it's not assets, it's your liability. Understand? So when you do any entry, there is no absolutely correlation between such account. No any correlation between expenses to assets. Sometimes it does, sometimes it does not. So for this example, it just happened to this way. Understand? So to learn the basic principle of financial accounting, you just remember five categories. And there is no absolute correlation to each one. You need to follow out what transaction is. Because in this transaction, we are doing the adjustment. We are doing the adjustment. So that's the reason why in this example, expenses correlated to prepaid rent. Only for this example. This is not general rule. It is not. So hopefully I answer your questions. Yeah, go ahead.
I think questions like that. I feel a little bit confusing.
I know that. I can see your face.
Normally, remember we talk about the first time talk about okay, asset go to the equity, and the other one actually is more like income statement, right? You have new cars plus your expense, you have your net profit, and the other one will be key into your assets account, right? But in this case, actually, one question: whether the expense belong to liability or equity or just
no,
doesn't belong to anything, right?
So in order to clarify your confusion, I know that. So this is why I want to go very, very slowly. I would rather go very slowly. I know. Let me repeat my answer to her. Eventually, it's my answer to you. For each transaction, those accounts, they can always cross around. For any specific transaction, it could be assets to assets, it could be assets to liability, it could be assets to equity, it could be assets to even to revenue, very strangely. So the answer to your questions is, you need to forgive your understanding, because your understanding was wrong. I know your understanding Before now, your understanding is for each transaction, it must be balance sheet to balance sheet, income statement to income statement. So I can guess, you already understand for income statement, only two accounts, revenue, expenses. So originally, you thought for every T account, it must be corresponding to either expenses to revenue or revenue to expenses, not across the board. No, it's not right. When I say revenue and expenses belong to income statement, I only mean those two numbers finally, not every day, finally, not every transaction, finally will appear only on the income statement. Or vice versa. When we read income statement, we only see the total number of revenue and the total number of expenses. And those total number, they are all added on from each single transaction. Okay? However, for each transaction, they can always cross the board. Always cross the board. So you need to give away your original thinking. So let me repeat that, okay? For each transaction, when we enter into tier account, those five elements, they can always cross the board. Always. Let me repeat that. For each transaction, you need to identify, you need to read transaction very clearly. And then you determine the possibility could be assets connect to expenses back here. Could be assets connect to revenue. could be assets connected to liability, could be assets connected to equity, could be liability connected to equity, could be liability connected to expenses, could be liability connected to revenue, any kind of thing.
So
very
that,
complicated.
So that what it means actually, you don't really care about so strictly
as a good liability. Yeah, because it's
the end product. Left side, right side,
the balance doesn't matter. Yes, this is that's the end product. When we say equity, I'm sorry, assets, liability, equity only appear on balance sheet. That's final product. That is not day-to-day accounting job, okay? When we do day-to-day accounting entry, those five elements, those five categories, they will always come in mixed together. Understand? So assets may relate to expenses. Assets may relate to revenue or any other kind of combination. This is the thing gonna happen. So far so good? So far so good, we'll move on. We'll give you more examples.
Is that possible asset related to asset?
Of course. He just mentioned how about assets to assets, which just happened. When you spend cash, this one asset, and then it happened to another two assets, security deposit and prepay. Any kind of combination you can mention. Maybe liability to liability. Maybe. Minus, okay. Maybe a little bit exaggerated, but it could be any kind of combination. So far, so good. So far, so good, right? All right now we start to consider about our cash because cash getting very low. And before this company make any sales, really worry about your owner, right? As a business owner, you start to worry about it. You only spend the money, but where is the money coming from?
Salary manager.
We'll get to that later on. Yes.
Wrong.
Yes, right now Mr. A say, well, I have cash, but I don't want to invest two more. I can put in another $5,000, but I don't want to put this $5,000 as capital. I want to loan to the company. And once the company make the sales, whenever the company got cash, I want to get it back. Legally speaking, yes, it's legal. No problem. As long as this is not public company, it's not public company, less regulation to prohibit the loan between the company to the shareholder. All right? So right now, for example, on certain day, Mr. A transfer another $5,000 cash to the corporation. However, this is the loan, say payable back in 30 days. Right? So to answer your questions, every time we need to read the transaction very carefully. And we don't care about is assets or liability or equity, not at this moment. Because that is the end result. As long as we read the transaction very carefully, it will lead us to the right track. Alright? So right now when the company receives $5,000 cash, what account you wanna pick?
Cash.
Cash. Then how about the other account? Right, this is a new account. We cannot create another new one. Because when the company receives 5,000 and you ask for what? What for? When company receives 5,000 for what? For a liability. For a new liability. The company incur a new liability. What? The company is liable to pay it back to Mr. A around 30 days. So we have a cash increase $5 here. And we create a new account liability, say note payable. It's not account payable, okay? Account payable usually means you purchase materials, inventory. You get a loan from anybody else. And everybody know, note payable is liability, right? So it's like this. So far, so good. Okay. By the end of the month, not only pay for the rent, also pay for the utility. Say $300 utility bill due by the end of the month. Or let me change it a little bit. By the end of the month, utility incurred $300. However, when Mr. A received the bill, he said it's payable by the 5th of next month. So your company does not have to pay right now by the end of the month. However, it incurred. Assuming your company is accrual method, okay, I should mention this earlier. For the accounting or for taxation, there are two major accounting systems. For the small business, usually we use cash method. We use cash method, meaning by the time you pay cash, then you enter into the accounting. But for financial accounting, okay, for this book, we always assume it is accrual method. Accrue mean happen or incur. So even though your company has not paid $300 yet, but by the end of the month it incur. So it's a little bit tough right now. It's a new example than the ones before we used. So right now, by the end of the month, your company incurred $300 utility. Let me put it there, it's expense, okay? However, your company has not paid yet. So how did you enter into your accounting?